Okay, so I've had a lot of requests from people wanting to know how to install OS 9 on an old computer. I would like to go ahead and point out, if you have come to this video from the internet looking for information on how to install OS 10 or any operating system on a Mac computer, if your computer is even in the least bit modern, such as made after, I don't know, 1999 or newer, this is probably not the video for you. This is for the older OS 9 that was used up until around 1999-2000. Nobody uses it anymore. The only people who would want it are for people who want to use some of the really old software. So just wanted to keep that in mind. Don't waste your time watching this. All right, on to the show.
Okay, so to get started, you'll need your OS 9 install disks. If you don't have one and need to know where to get one, then wait until the end of the video. So put your OS 9 CD in the optical drive. Hold down the C key and power on the computer. It's important that you continue to hold the C key down until you see the operating system starting up. Expect it to sit here on the screen for a while. Eventually, you'll get this screen and continue to wait for some more. I mean quite a while. Go make yourself a snack or a cup of coffee or something. Eventually, you should get to your desktop. Don't be tempted to click this macOS install icon. Instead, scroll down and open up the utilities and eventually drive setup. Okay, you'll see two drives listed. One is the actual OS 9 CD-ROM. The other one is listed is not mounted because it's never been initialized since this is a brand new drive. In this case, go ahead and click the hard drive and then initialize. It won't take very long and you'll see the new drive is called Untitled. So, close the drive setup program. You'll see the new drive mounted on the desktop. I'll go ahead and rename mine now to iBook HD, as that sounds better than Untitled. Okay, now you can close that folder and scroll back up to find the macOS install icon. The install is pretty straightforward. First, you select the disk, which in this case we only have one to pick from. Then there'll be a lot of clicking continue and agreeing to terms and etc. Eventually, you can start the install. This will take a few minutes, probably even longer than it took to boot from the CD. Okay, so we're just about done now. And of all of the bizarre questions, it will ask you if you want to continue or quit. Well, actually, you want to quit. Then go onto the top menu and select Special, then Restart. This time it will be booting from the hard drive and things should go much faster. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and plug in a network cable and see if I can connect to my modern OS 10 file server using this old OS 9. So click the Apple, then Control Panels, then TCP/IP. I'm going to select Ethernet built in because that's how I'm connecting. You should get an IP address from your DHCP server. I know my network and I recognize this configuration as being valid for my network. Okay, next thing to do is click on the Apple icon and select Chooser. Click Apple Share and then enter the server address. In this case, I'm putting the IP address of my file server. I'll need to change the username to mine and put in my password. And I already know it's working because I've been given a list of volumes that I can mount. I'll check the ones I want and then click OK. After a few seconds, the volumes are mounted and show up on my desktop. Browsing the web on OS 9 is an exercise in frustration and futility. It has Internet Explorer, but it's so old it won't render anything besides the most basic of websites. You can use it to download Classilla, but you'll even find it is severely outdated and will not render most websites correctly. If you try to open a website like Facebook, it will give you a mobile version of the website. But now I can install and play Lemmings.
Well, I hope you're able to follow the install video. I would like to point out a couple things. A lot of people always email me and they ask me where Can I buy these old CDs for, you know, OS 9 or even OS 10 for that matter? And they want to know if they can buy them from me. And of course, I don't have anywhere that I can get them. The only place I can get them is buying them on eBay or Craigslist. And, you know, sometimes I get them with some old computers that come in with, you know, the business I was running sometimes. But ultimately, when people ask me the question, the answer is always the same. You need to go to eBay or Craigslist if you want to buy a copy of the software. It's not very expensive because it's old and not very many people want it. You can usually pick it up for a few bucks. I would also point out, it is typically possible to download the software from a BitTorrent site. Now, ethically speaking, I'm really okay with that because Apple doesn't sell this software anymore. They haven't sold it in like 13 years or some, you know, astronomical number like that. So you're not really hurting their bottom line by downloading really obsolete software that they don't sell anymore. But the reason I often don't recommend downloading from a BitTorrent site is because the next question that always follows is, well, which site should I get it from? And of course, they go up and down all the time, and there's no guarantee this any site that I named today will even exist 2 weeks from now. And even if it did, then the very next question that will follow is, well, how do I download a BitTorrent? What torrent software do I need? And then, how do I burn the CD? What software do I need to burn the CD? What if I want to burn the CD on a Windows computer? And blah, 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 blah. And so it just goes on and on and on and on and on. And so I usually just try to avoid even talking about the whole burning of the CDs. If that's something you want to do, there are probably plenty of websites that will explain how to do that. You can go Google for that. But just please don't email me asking me how to do it, because I don't have 2 hours to write a dissertation on how it's to be done. But so anyway, that's basically the three ways that you can get the CD. You can buy it online like eBay, or you can find somebody local on Craigslist who's got one, or you can download it and burn it. Take your pick. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and I got an OS X install video coming up next.